Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good morning, all. Ira Epstein of Linn Associates with your morning flash update, and this is for Thursday, the 1st of February, 2018, about 9:15 a.m. Central Standard Time. First announcement, I am getting ready to launch our first webinar. I'm assuming it'll be next week. I was going to do it this week, actually, this whole time, and then we're testing it here to be certain that the experience for you is as good as we can make it. That's the right way to say this. As for other parts of what we're doing, I think you're going to find that the market volatility is starting to pick up, and it's something you want to pay attention to. Each day now, we're getting a lot more violent move in the markets, in the stock indices. Now, when I say violent, not in a percentage basis. I was on Fox yesterday, Business TV, and I mentioned, I was talking to Liz Klayman, and I said, you know, Liz, we're seeing 300-point moves in the Dow, and people are getting upset. But when you're at 26,000, a 1% move is 260 points. That's not very big. So all you're getting here is because prices are higher, volatility's come back in, which is something we all are looking forward to. If you take a look at the metal markets, they're all down a little bit today, not big, into some key support areas. The dollar's still a bit lower at the expense of other currencies. The yen's one of the currencies that was down more than most, but it's bounced off the lows, and if it can start making new highs on the day, it would get to be an interesting looking chart. Right back up in the energy. So no matter what we keep hearing, this market has found a lot of area in the 65 where it breaks down, can't continue to the downside, gets much over it, can't continue to the upside. Sort of locked in on that $65 zone, which is interesting. Nat gas getting hit again. They're at 9:30 today, coming out with a report on the nat gas, and we'll get an idea of the size of it. Now, if we look at what's going on, today, Goldman Sachs is suggesting that the environment period in commodities is the best it's been since the 2004 through 2008 period. And you know what happened in 2008? That's when we entered basically bear markets as the stock market started its rebound. They're recommending overweighting the commodity sector, adding declining and already low levels in inventories will push prices back from these current historic low levels. ISM U.S. manufacturing recap came in at 59.1. They were expecting 58.5. Prices were up a little bit. All the other numbers fit right in. Not a bad report any way you go through it. Construction spending for December, that was up. It was up 7/10. They expected up 3/10. They took a 10th back in November, but you still made that up for December. Market U.S. Final manufacturing sector PMI came in at 55.5. They expected 55.4. That doesn't add to the market bullish or bearishness. Market January, I said this, I copied it wrong twice. The jobless claims came in down 1,000 at 230. Okay, nothing there to move the market either. Labor costs, now this is always expensive. They're not here. This is a bit of a problem. They're down 1/10. They were expected up 6/10. So that's not the best thing that you can see. And if you take a look, though, for the fourth quarter, unit labor costs went up. So you have to balance the two, but I'm still concerned with non-farm productivity. Challenger, the 2018 planned layoffs, 44,653, that's up 37% compared to the prior month. That's quite a bit of a number. Market Group's January PMI for China, 51.5, unchanged from December, and they had expected a small decrease, so that's favorable. And the head economist at the ECB said that inflation remains weak and the bank should continue with its stimulus measures. So when you put that all together, it gets very interesting. And the question is, what does that actually mean for the euro? And I think that's where the market's going to be playing games back and forth today, trying to figure that out. In the grain markets, We're seeing a sell-off from the recent prices. If you see the March beans take out 983 and three quarters on the chart, that could make the market look ugly. So this is the area where I would look for the bulls to try to support the market. I want to remind you all about our chart of the day, and I haven't mentioned this this year. I don't think I brought it up. You get a pattern like this, or a pattern where you have sideways action. It starts up, falls back, and then it starts taking off. Where might the markets go? Each day of the week, we put out what's called the chart of the day. It's yours if you'd like to try it. How do you do it? Give us a call. Go to our website. It'll all come to you. We'll send emails. You get alerts to it. You click a button, and it just opens up on your computer. You can do it right here if you're watching me on YouTube or underneath us. It says click here for Ira's free information on sites that we're on in other areas, and we'll take it from there. I'm Ira Epstein. I'll talk to you this afternoon. You have a great trading day.